हेलो एंड वेलकम टू थ्योरी कोर्स जीआईएस एंड रिमोट सेंसिंग KOI 066। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग दैट व्हाट इज रिमोट सेंसिंग एंड व्हाट आर द वेरियस कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ रिमोट सेंसिंग। द कंटेंट्स फॉर डिस्कशन इन दिस लेक्चर विल बी डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ रिमोट सेंसिंग इंक्लूडिंग एनर्जी सोर्स इंटरेक्शन विद द टारगेट and sensors. So we have already discussed about the technique of remote sensing. So we'll be just again glimpsing about that. So what is remote sensing? So it is a technique that enables us or that makes possible to gain information or to obtain data about a particular place or about a particular site without getting into physical contact with that object or that feature. So basically we can have some information, that information may be of any kind for which will serve our purpose, but the objective is that we want to gather information without getting into physical contact with that feature. So here in this figure we can see that what are the various kind of we can say that components that are involved in a complete process of remote sensing. So we are having one source that is emitting some radiations. So those radiations are coming to the surface of Earth. Those radiations are striking the objects, or we can more appropriately say that these electromagnetic radiations are interacting with the surface features. And after interacting, this electromagnetic radiations or incident radiations or incoming solar radiations, after interacting with the target, these are getting reflected as reflected radiations and are finally getting back to a particular place, that is your, we can say that, platforms. So what are those platforms? Those are satellites on which sensors are mounted. So those sensors are sensing those reflected electromagnetic radiations. We have seen that finally all those reflected radiations that come from the surface of Earth, so those information is in the form of electromagnetic radiations, and there are several bands in which electromagnetic radiations are present. So we have classified several bands of electromagnetic radiations. So those reflected electromagnetic bands are finally coming towards sensors which are mounted on satellites. So we will now see that what are the various components of remote sensing. So before discussing the various components, I will just again discuss that figure with you, and which we will have an overview that what are the different components. So basically in remote sensing, what is happening, what is the principle? If we talk about the principle of remote sensing, then principle is reflection, and we can say that radiation and reflection of electromagnetic waves. So who is the person who is completing, or what is the thing that is completing this whole process? So those important thing is, that important thing is electromagnetic radiations. So due to the presence of electromagnetic radiations, we can have information about any kind of object. So obviously the question comes that where the electromagnetic radiations will come from. Okay, so we need to have some electromagnetic radiations in our system, and those electromagnetic radiations will be interacting with the objects or features, and then they will be reflecting from those features, and finally we will be receiving those electromagnetic radiations at the sensors, and we will be obtaining some signals, or we can say we will be obtaining some information about that. So the thing is that we need to have some electromagnetic radiations. So we need to have a source that will be able to generate or produce some electromagnetic radiations. So we have one natural source that is sufficiently capable of generating infinite amount of electromagnetic radiations. Yes, we have sun. So sun is, from the sun we are able to receive electromagnetic radiations. Okay, so those electromagnetic radiations will come from a source. So we need to have the source. So our first component is source, to have a source. So we should definitely have a source that is able to generate some electromagnetic radiations. The case may be that that source which is capable of generating electromagnetic radiations, that can be natural or that can be artificial. That is some another portion. But for starting the process, so the first component should be to have a source of electromagnetic radiations. So for this case, we are having sun as a natural source that is able to generate electromagnetic radiations. So after these radiations are generated, these are coming towards the earth. So we are calling those radiations as incident solar radiations. Okay. Somewhere these are also called as incoming solar radiations. So these incident solar radiation, they will travel in space. They will travel in space and they will finally reach to earth. So before coming to the surface of earth, they will be traveling through atmosphere of earth. And due to presence of several kinds of, we can say, constituents of atmosphere, so our atmosphere behaves separately for this electromagnetic radiations. So it allows partial transmission of electromagnetic waves. It allows selective transmission of electromagnetic waves. Not whole of that electromagnetic spectrum band is transmitted through the atmosphere of Earth. Selective electromagnetic radiations are able to pass through the atmosphere of Earth and finally reach to the surface of Earth. So those portion we will be dealing with, we'll be discussing them separately. Those are called as atmospheric windows. So now after these electromagnetic radiations has reached to the surface of Earth, now they will come and strike, or we will more appropriately call it is that these incoming solar radiations, while reaching to the surface of Earth, these will interact with the surface features. So what may be surface features? So there may be vegetation, there may be trees, there may be water bodies, there may be grass, there may be bare soil or sand, there may be some paved surface, there may be houses, built up area. So there can be numerous kind of features. So depending upon the type of feature, there is unique percentage of reflectance that is observed. And then finally, after interacting with the surface features, those radiations will be reflected back to the atmosphere. And while those radiations are reflected back, this will be gathered by sensors. So where are sensors? So these sensors are mounted on some platform. So what is a platform? So basically, it is here satellite. So these satellites are just a carrier for, or we can say it is just a platform for sensors. So these sensors will sense these reflected solar radiations, and some information will be perceived, which will be transferred to later on to the end users and monitor stations. So now let's have some discussion on components. So the first components we need to have is energy source or illumination. We need to have some source that is able to generate electromagnetic radiations. Okay. So the first requirement is to have an energy source so that will be able to generate or provide some electromagnetic energy so that we can have some interaction with the targets. Okay. So depending upon the source, there may be sources that are able to generate electromagnetic radiations on its own. So I'm just talking about some man-made sources, not about natural sources. So depending upon the type of source, we can categorize that we can have natural sources of electromagnetic radiations, or we can have different sources that are able to generate and record on their own electromagnetic radiations. So depending on this, we have two types of technique, that's it, namely which are active remote sensing and passive remote sensing. So if we are using some technique which are using some natural radiations, which are sensing natural radiations which are either emitted or reflected from the earth, so this type of technique is called as passive remote sensing. And the sensors which record those, which perform this type of techniques, those sensors are called as passive sensors. Okay. And on the other hand, if you are using some source that is natural, that is not natural source, that is able to generate, produce artificially electromagnetic radiations, so such type of sources are called as active remote sensing. Those technique is called as active remote sensing, and those sensors which record such artificially generated electromagnetic radiations, those are called as active sensors. Okay, so depending upon the type of source, we have two techniques. We have active remote sensing, we have passive remote sensing. So if we are using natural sources as a source, then we are obviously performing passive remote sensing. If we are using some artificial sources to generate electromagnetic radiations, then we are performing active remote sensing. So we have discussed that depending upon the source, we can have active or passive remote sensing. So active sensors, those have their own energy source for illumination, and passive remote sensors, these record natural radiations that are generated from sun. So here we can see that there is one natural source, that is sun, and it is generating huge amount of electromagnetic radiations. These electromagnetic radiations are finally reaching to the surface of Earth after selective transmission, and finally these are getting reflected and are getting recorded at sensors which are mounted on satellites. So this type of techniques is, this is your passive remote sensing, because we are using sun as the source of energy. Suppose we are not using sun as the source of energy, we are using some artificial source that is able to generate remote that are able to generate electromagnetic radiations on its own. So let's say we have some instruments that are mounted on the same satellites or sensors that are able to generate also those electromagnetic radiations. So these sensors are able to produce electromagnetic radiations, and those electromagnetic radiations, after interacting with the Earth's surface features, those are getting back and recorded by the sensor. So this type of technique is called as active remote sensing. Next, interaction with the target. So once the electromagnetic radiations pass through the solar system and finally reach to the Earth, before reaching the Earth, they are interacting with Earth's atmosphere also. So we will be dealing. So there are some many we can say that many observations, or we can say that many process or many operations are getting there. So selective band of electromagnetic radiations is available only for performing this type of techniques. So why it is happening? What is that process which allows only certain wavelengths to pass through? That we will be discussing again. So it is more appropriate to call it as scattering. So selective scattering is taking place. So that phenomena which is happening in the Earth atmosphere, that is selective scattering, or we can say absorption is also getting place. So whole of the electromagnetic spectrum band is not getting fully transmitted. Some portions only are getting transmitted, and these are finally reaching to the Earth. So when they are reaching to the Earth and striking these objects or features that are present on Earth, so that portion is called as, or that action is called as interaction with the target. Okay, so those surface features are your targets. So that electromagnetic radiation, incoming or incident solar radiation, interacts or strikes the targets. Okay, then some of the portion may be absorbed, some of the portion may be transmitted, some of the portion is reflected. Okay, while interaction with the target. So that reflected portion that is getting reflected back, that portion is now getting sensed by the sensors, and then properties can be visualized according to those radiations. So now while interaction has been completed, interaction with the object has been completed, those rays have finally reached back to the sensors. So now comes the role of sensors into the picture. So after though, and that energy has been scattered or emitted from the target, so there is one sensor that collects and records those electromagnetic radiations. Okay, these sensors are popularly known as EMR sensors, because these operate in EMR ranges. So it will depend on the which type of electromagnetic band you are using for performing remote sensing. So majorly, or we can say more commonly, we are having optical and microwave remote sensing. So depending upon the type of wavelength or band which you are using, we can have different type of sensors also. Now platform. So basically platform is that station that is having those instruments which are performing actual operations. So we can say that we have seen that sensors are able to sense those information and record those electromagnetic radiations. But where are these sensors located? So these sensors are mounted on a certain platforms. So those platforms may be space bound, those platforms may be airborne. So in some cases we can also use airborne platforms like aircrafts on which sensors are mounted, and we can also have some platforms that are in space. So we can have space-borne platform also, we can have airborne platform also. So generally satellites, those come in space-borne platform. So generally for a stable technique we are using satellite. So basically satellite is your platform that is having sensors which records those reflected radiations. So transmission, reception and processing. So that energy which has been sensed by the sensor, it has to be transmitted, and it has to be converted in some electronic form in the form of a signal, so that it can be sent back to the Earth at the transmission stations, at the monitor stations. So those information can be received, and that can be verified and rectified, and can be converted in a digital form, so that the end users or the person who are interested in gaining the data of remote sensing can work on them. Now after this is the last step, so whole of that process is completed, and finally we are on the office and we are having those remote sense data. Now we have to analyze that data, or we have to interpret data. So basically, we are having some specialized instruments, we are having some specialized softwares with the help of which we are analyzing those spatial data and getting our desired or fruitful results. So those techniques by which, with the help of which we are able to, we can say that improve the quality of those images if we are capturing images and enhance the quality of images. So those particular type of steps are steps comes under the category of digital image processing. So this is one of the topic which we will be discussing later on in detail. So some of the steps which we generally perform in digital image processing is image correction, or we can say restoration, then image enhancement, improving the contrast levels, image transformation. So these type of correcting the geometry, correcting the colors, connecting the tonal value, these type of operations are being performed in digital image processing. So this was all for this lecture. So we have seen that what is remote sensing technique and what are the different type of components, what is the role of different components involved in a remote sensing system. Thank you.